Man is scared of mirrors, let the story commence. Craig moved in with his girlfriend. You see, he was actually staying with a flatmate, and they got together, and things were going steady, as they say in America, and things were starting to get heavy. They were going steady. His flatmate had moved out, and he couldn't pay the rent by himself. And he went, what a day, I've got to get somebody. And his girlfriend said, well, you could move in with me, you know, until, you know, maybe you could find a weird place, run, try to find a new flat, you know, so, you know, for a month or two, and then, you know, you can get your own place or whatever. He went, all right. The two of them were kind of skirting around what they were thinking, which is like maybe we just move in, but no one to come right out and say it. Nobody want to scare anybody. Nobody want to scare anybody. And he moved in. And he moved in at night. It was night time. He had a lot of stuff to kind of move it during the day. And he came here at night. He saw the lights were off. It was all dark, so he couldn't see anything. Like if there was anything on the wall, for example. It was all dark, so he couldn't see anything. Just, that's the way it was. The electricity was off. Something happened. Right, so he couldn't see anything. Like if there's any pictures on the wall, or for example, let's say mirrors. Could see if there's any mirrors. Because it was night time when he got there, you see. So he couldn't see anything. So he moved in at night time. You know when you arrive at a hotel at night? And then he got up during the night about 2 in the morning to get a drink of water. He didn't really know his way about the house. So he switched on a light in the hall. Mirrors everywhere. It was her thing. Instead of putting lots of pictures up on the wall, she put up lots of different types of mirrors, different types of frames and things like that. In the hall, there was a mirror on that side, a mirror on the other ones, a bit of kind of infinity sort of thing going on here and there. Unfortunately, he was scared of mirrors. So here's what he did. He shat it. He screamed, turned away from that mirror, saw the other one in the other direction, reflecting that other one. Punched one of the mirrors instinctively. And then he started spinning around. And he ran into the kitchen, and there's even more mirrors in there. And she came down and went, what's going on? Oh my God, what's going on? Has somebody broke in? And he shouted, I broke my fist into the mirror out there. Help! Mirrors! She went, here, what's the mirror that you broke? He went, it's out there in the hall, and he went like that. She went out, picked up a bit of the mirror. And she went, look. Look. And then she pure squeezed it. Right? Fucking cut her horn. He went, what you doing? She went, we can both be fucking mental. He went, what you doing? He went, what am I doing? What are you fucking doing? Lying there on the ground, stabbed to death. He went, what are you on about? And then she stabbed it into his neck. And as she was stabbing, the mirror cut right into the fuck, right down to the bone. Right down to the bone. As she was going like that, you could hear. Because even though Craig was a bit mental. She was really fucking mental. She's really mental. Fade to black. A new day. A new boyfriend comes in at night and says, "Oh, thanks for letting me move in with you while I get a new flat." This is a new boyfriend. "I'm so happy to get away from my old flatmate." There's somebody else. "There was too many mirrors in there, and you know what I'm like with mirrors. I don't like them." Ah, the end. Ah. So it's like a thing she does. Ah. So it's kind of like a thing she does. Ah. It's not open-ended. You fill it in by yourself.